Hey y'all, Nikki Golden here with another video in my series, Why You Like This Song. Today's song comes to us by a band called Anberlin, and it's called The Unwinding Cable Car. In this video, I'm going to do a little reaction to hearing the song, and then I'm going to do a little analysis of some of the music theory elements that make this song good and try to explain it in a way that's not going to get overly complicated. As always, make sure you like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell. I'm not going to play the whole song in this video, but if you'd like to check out the whole song, possibly even before the video, check out the link in the description. All right, here we go. Anberlin, The Unwinding Cable Car. Okay, right out the gate, we've got a little ostinato, a little counter melody. Solid intro here.
Go your own way, even seasons have changed, just burn those new.
Nice singing and a nice use of the delay effect on the voice.
So self-absorbed, you seem to ignore the prayers that have already come over.
Little counter melody in the guitar. Ooh, little layered vocals here, like that. Doubling up that melody. Alright, added a little bit of that jingle jangle tambourine percussion there. Maybe a shaker, yep, shaker right here there. Sounds like the guitar's capoed up pretty high, at least one of the guitar layers. That's pretty cool.
Don't you believe that you've been deceived, that you're no better.
That note's in every chord, a little pedal note.
Never disguise what you really
Oh man, there it is again. The one vocal fades out, the other vocal fades in. Good production work. Harmonies, solid. Cool, cool. Ooh! Bringing the drums now, huh? Blowing a little emphasis on the front side of the beat, on the downbeats here, on the snare drum, as opposed to the kind of the tambourine on the backbeat earlier. Again, cool vocal layers.
Cool.
Really great vocal work with all the separate melodies and harmonies here. A little rock on that part with the voice. I wonder, I haven't listened to this band a lot. I wonder if they do like more emo sounding stuff every once in a while. Cool. Cool little turnaround there. It's hard to keep track of all those different vocal parts. Alright, finally the bass player gets in here. I would assume live the bass player is one of the backup vocals, otherwise what a long time to go without playing. Ooh. A little melody in that bass part too. Cool. Cool guitar part. Arpeggios. Love them. Doo-doo-dee. Although there's a little melodic bit in there, not just all arpeggiated. Oh! Oh, I thought the song was over. Oh, it is. Oops, autoplay YouTube. We get to talk about a lot of cool things with this video. We get to talk about ostinato parts and pedal notes, and we get to talk about a lot of cool like interweavings of what we call counter melody, both in the guitars and in the vocals. There's some pretty sweet percussion stuff going on in this song. Bass player does play a pretty tasty line once they come in. All right, first, we're going to talk about ostinato. Ostinato and pedal notes, which is something we'll talk about here in a second, very similar things. It's a repeated pattern that happens over different chord changes throughout a melody or a set of chord changes. And we get that right at the beginning in this guitar part. When the next guitar comes in, that's still gonna play even though that guitar is changing chords. Also, there's a cool bit of dissonance in that part right here. I don't know if this is 100% correct, but nope. That's pretty close. Let's double check and see if that was right. Just going off the top of my head here. Yeah, so a little bit of dissonance in this part. Where we get these two notes that are right next to each other. And that kind of unnerves you a little bit, because if you just hear those two notes by themselves, well. And then these two notes, also right next to each other. As a melody, just fine. But played where they ring out like this, we get that little bit of dissonance, which is, again, sounds that just kind of clash together. And it kind of gives us a slight uneasy feeling, but the notes are high enough in the sound spectrum that it's not, like, gonna freak us out or be gross. And that's called ostinato. Pretty cool thing, and it's related to pedal. And pedal notes, as I search feverishly for the capo that is connected to the top of my guitar. So a pedal note is a note that rings out through all the chords. If we play it with this capo on right here, these chords are gonna sound a lot higher than they would in the regular position. If I played it in the regular position, it would sound like this, which is a cool sounding chord, but sounds a lot cooler for this song up here. And by moving the capo, not only do I make the chord higher, it changes what the chord actually is as well. And now we get this note in every one of these chords. I just heard this song a few seconds ago, so I'm not sure of the strum pattern, and I'm pretty sure those are the right chords, but these are reaction videos and I'm reacting and that's what I hear. So that's pedal notes and that's ostinato. Basically two different devices of us keeping notes solid throughout different chords, always giving us a slight little feeling of, I don't know. I mean, it's cool, but it's not exactly 100% cool. I'm a big fan of pedal notes and ostinato parts. That brings us to counterpoint. That happens in the multiple layers of guitar. That also happens in the multiple layers of vocal. And that's a really cool thing. You'll find that a lot in classical music. And it just takes us to an extra layer of things that's happening around us. So it keeps the song moving, it keeps the song progressing. Let's go forward a little bit. Let's hear some of that in the guitar. So we get that melody from earlier, sort of. Be-da-da-da, bum, 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 bum. And that right now serves as just a melody, but later in the song that's gonna come back with the vocals providing a counter melody. Speaking of that, let's roll forward and listen to some of those vocals. Go your own way, even seasons have changed. First off, there's that delay effect in the vocals now. Go your own way, way, way. Love delay, favorite effect. Well, top three. So there we are in the chorus. We got, this is the, again, you come for the instruments, not the singing, folks. This is the correlation. While the guitar is playing that be-da-da-da melody. So again, we get our nice little bit of counterpoint, but then of salvation, love. Don't drop your love. Don't drop your love. So the second voice comes in, which is probably still the original singer. It's just another vocal track. Don't drop your love, because the first part is still kind of hanging over. And then don't drop your love comes in with a harmony. So even if it is the same singer singing all of this, it's been recorded in such a way that these are like different parts being passed around. It's pretty neat. So some songs that you've heard have multiple instruments and voices singing the same melody or unison. This can be really effective if you think about big sing-along songs like Hey Jude or things like that. Simple melodies that kind of everybody can sing. Now this isn't the simplest of melodies, but it's catchy enough. And when the guitar and the vocal are both singing it, I guarantee you at some point listening to this song, I'm also going to be going, ba-da-da-da. You know, shaking my head. All right, let's keep exploring.
Backing away from the problem of pain, you never had a home.
At this point, we've had some percussion enter. A little jingle jangle, a little sparkle. We got this tambourine, it's hitting the backbeats. 2 and 4 of a measure of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll probably say that in almost every video. And then we also get a shaker, real subtle on eighth notes. And eighth notes, if we're counting 1, 2, 3, 4, they're just twice as fast. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and and that keeps the groove going, especially now that we've gotten through a verse and a chorus, and we're gonna come back to another verse and another chorus. It just gives us something to keep our heads nodding, keeps us moving, and keeps us paying attention. Harmony is when we have two voices or instruments playing notes at the same time that go together and work together to make a chord. You can move harmonies through melodies, both parts will move. And there's some excellent harmonies right here. Let's check it out. Really cool part. It's fun to sing those parts live too. If you're the harmony vocalist, way up there at the top. Don't you believe? I already warned you once. All right, so when we get back to the chorus, we've added some more vocal parts that are really neat. There's this one part where we have sort of a kind of a counter melody situation going on that's going to join us into a harmony situation. It's really fun. Let's take a listen. So the don't drop your love part, the lower notes sang first and they held their note while that higher part, don't drop your love, came in. And as the chord changed, those voices hit that longer note at the same time and created a cool chord as it faded out and the next part kept going. Really cool way to keep these separated different vocal parts running and mixing together. So as a listener, not only do you have these cool experiences of the chords, but it never stops. It keeps you flowing and it keeps coming out of different places. Pretty fun to do as a listener, pretty fun to do as a creator. Those drums come in and you can't help but go shake your head, right? And part of it is the snare drum that would normally be on the backbeat, as mentioned earlier about backbeat, now is playing on the downbeats. It's not a very loud snare, it's not a very in-your-face snare, but just that rhythm alone kind of keeps it pumping. Now downbeats, of course, are where if you're listening to music and you're patting your foot, every time your foot hits the ground, or you're nodding your head, and every time your head goes down, that's a downbeat. And that snare drum, bop, bop, bop. Of course, snare drum being the higher pitched, crackier sounding drum, as opposed to like a kick drum, which has a boomy sound, or the toms, doo-ga-doo-ga-doom. Snare drum's that, ga, ga. So coming in on that one really propels the song forward. In a lot of music, snare drum is used for backbeat, so it's nice to get that flip and get it pushing. So let's check out the next part. In this part of the song, we're getting a preview of that guitar part at the ending with that boom, 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 boom. Not necessarily a full-on ostinato part unless you consider that whole thing to be ostinato. I think of it more as it's just sort of own melody filling up that space. We can think about it whatever we want. All we know is it's cool. That's what matters. But you'll hear it in the background behind the vocals. And of course, this section now we have all of these really great flowing in and around our original bit of melody that was already popping around. So we've added more vocal layers, and all of these vocal layers again are washing together to create this kind of sea of sound that we're swimming in. And it just kind of between that push of the drums and all that, and that sea of sound, now we're just really in a moving space as a listener. And then finally the bass player gets to play. I know I just said, and this is when the bass comes in, and all the bass players of the world, bass players of the world, unite, but also only be the only one in a band. Just kidding. But I totally forgot about this kind of more aggressive emo rock style vocal, which I remember, I think I said during the reaction, I wonder if this band does any emo music. The singer gets a little wow in the vocal. Kind of cool. I mean, at this point, we're 3 minutes into a 4 minute song. We're getting juiced up with the song direction. It's time to add a little energy. We've added those drums. The whole world's gonna explode once the bass comes in. Don't worry, bass is coming. It's coming. Let's keep exploring. Whoever the bass player is in this band, I appreciate the work you just did as a fellow bass player. You didn't just keep it to playing do-do-do-do, eighth notes. You threw those little melodies in. You doubled the actual melody. You put your own little walking line in there. You may have only gotten like 15 seconds of a 4 minute song, but you killed those 15 seconds. Keep doing the good work of fighting the good fight, bass players. All right, bass player corner's over. Cool ending. We got that guitar part that we had from before that was behind the vocals now being the future player. And I love how they let that last note fade all the way out instead of cutting it off a little too soon. Good flow for the end. Okay, so we've listened to the song, The Unwinding Cable Car by Anberlin. Pretty groovy tune. Definitely surprised me when those drums came in the first listen through. I didn't know that was going to happen. There's lots of cool ostinato and pedal notes. We get all these kind of weaving vocal parts that come in and out, drenched in delay and reverb. For a solid 10 to 15 seconds, pretty killer bass line. That's right, I still got your back, whoever you are. All in all, this song takes us several places, and it's a fun ride to get there that it seems like there's never a lull or a dead part. They bring it up and they bring it down, but there's always something that captures your attention. Definitely a song that if you wanted to hear all of the parts that are being played throughout the different layers of guitar, it's going to take you a couple of listens. Really great suggestion for us here on the channel today. Don't forget to do what every YouTube video always ever tells you to do. Like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Also, put a song that you like in the comments, and I'll try to make a video for that song to tell you why you like that song. As always, peace out, and I'll see you next time.